Yo, 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 it's Big Ant back with another edition of Urban Politicians TV, Raw and Uncut. Had to come speak on something real quick. Tiger going on Nicki Minaj's radio station, man, you know what I'm saying? To me, bro, you know, you gotta understand how people doing you, dog. Like, you gotta understand when somebody using you and it ain't smart. This right here for the young niggas, dog. And this ain't no disrespect to Tiger. I really don't like covering these type of stories for the mess and all that type of shit. That ain't really what I'm on. But, you know, I got a little clip of it. Bro, for my young rappers, my young niggas coming up in the game, take it from a nigga who made mistakes, who done shit in relationships or, like, getting other people involved and shit with you and your gal or your exes, bro. Keep all your shit with your ex private, bro. Like, 100. Don't get on the radio stations talking about her. Ain't nothing good gonna come of it. That shit gonna be the talk of the day. But the fact that you spoke on your ex gal, that shit gonna follow you forever, dog. Don't do it. You know what I'm saying? You gonna always look like the bad person in them situations. I salute Tiger, nigga. Got respect for how that nigga hustling and how he grind. You know what I'm saying? Nigga be doing his motherfucking thing, hit after hit. Nigga would love to be in that position of him making that music and doing his motherfucking thing with them bangers he had, which I heard he never got paid for because the business weren't right. So he supposed to be trying to get that shit squared away with Cash Money. But I'm speaking on the aspect, nigga, of don't go on the radio because it's a trendy topic or Nicki Minaj wants you on there, whoever wants you on there. Don't go on there speaking about what you did for your ex or how you helped her out because the girl ain't spoke on you. You know what I'm saying? He's saying that he brought her to black culture and introduced her to the black people. Yeah, you probably played a little role, bro, but one thing about black people, we attracted to money, bro. That's just what it is. I don't care how you slice the pie, how you try to edge it up, cut it up, piece it up. If it's some money involved, motherfucking black people got they into the streets. You know what I'm saying? We looking. Then on top of that, if you got money and your family fuck with niggas, niggas is really watching. So Kim K been rocking with niggas. Chloe been fucking with niggas. The mama fuck with niggas. The only one ain't fucking with niggas is Courtney. Everybody else tied to niggas, man. They got damn family, you know what I'm saying? Worked on the trial with OJ Simpson and shit. Bro, they already had black culture in them, man. If anything, Kim brought the whole family to black culture. So they been under this scope. Yeah, black people accepted them all, but man, let's be clear, dog. Kylie Jenner was gonna eat regardless. Now, you might have gave her some little swag tips or things like that, bro, but it just, I'm saying this, it ain't nothing good gonna come of a nigga going on a radio station with another female talking about another female. Now, if you wanted to keep it kind of simple, bro, you could just say, yeah, man, you know, we was rocking together. We rocked, you know what I'm saying? She gave me some game, I gave her some game, but don't go on there when you talking to a person that's an enemy. You understand? Nicki Minaj, enemy to Kylie Jenner right now, bro. She up here talking about the girl baby, talking about the girl baby daddy, which is Travis Scott. And then what's so crazy about this, before I get off this topic, Nicki Minaj just showed us like 2-3 times that she don't even really fuck with you like that, Tiger. Like, nigga, she was on that whole, like in 2014, nigga, when Tiger came out and said he was no longer with Cash Money. He was tired of them. They weren't paying him no money. He said they was foul, said they been doing them dirty. He was like, man, I got nothing but love and respect for Wayne. Ain't no problems with nobody else. He said, me and Drake don't really see eye to eye. But he was just like, hey, man, I ain't really rocking with Cash Money. I'm trying to get off that label. We going to court right now. They ain't gave me $1. Mac Maine and Nicki Minaj hopped on Twitter and said that they wasn't rocking with Tiger. Like, fuck Tiger. He ain't with Cash Money. He ain't with Young Money. Fuck him. You know what I'm saying? It's so crazy because that's how Mac Maine and Nicki Minaj jumped out there with it. Later on that year is when Lil Wayne came out and said that he didn't want to be on Cash Money no more. That he trying to get off the label. I ain't never hear Nicki Minaj come out publicly apologize to that man Tiger for saying that shit. Then a couple, like a week or two ago, she threw the nigga under the bus for the hair transplant shit. and that shit wasn't even necessary for her to do, for her to get her point across. So I just be like, bro, you gotta be smarter, bro. But for my young nigga, bro, don't ever go on a radio station with your ex-gal, somebody that's beefing with your ex-gal or your ex-gal situation and speak on it. It just ain't smart. Urban Politicians TV, Big Ant. Make sure y'all tap in with us. We got more coming, more content, all the above, man. 100.